Thank you. giver of every good and perfect gift, and the lover of our souls. We come, Father God, to your house one more time to give thanks to you for the life of one of your children, Sister Shelley. We thank your Heavenly Father for the privilege of watching her grow from infancy to being a grown woman and a mother. We thank you, O God, for times of pleasure and joy. We thank you, God, even for times when we disagreed because it didn't last forever. But God, we know one who does last forever, and that's you. We ask you, Heavenly Father, to show up and show out in this service today. May someone who came with tears in their eyes leave with a sense of knowing that you are the God who is always there for his children. We pray, Lord God, that words spoken will be spoken from the heart, they may touch our lives, not just for a day, not just for a season, but forever. So have your way, O God. Have your way, O God. Have your way, O God. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Let the people of God say, to the service celebration. Notice what the word here is, not funeral, but celebration. Yes. For a wonderful lady, for the life that she lived, and most of all, for the God whom she committed herself to. It may have come a little bit late, but she got in before the finish line. And we praise God for pray that something will be said or done today that will be a blessing to your heart, and your heart, and your heart. And that we will leave here today knowing no mistakes have been made, but God's will has been done. We shall continue now with our scripture readings.
Grace and peace to you all from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. The word of God says, blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Yes. The word also tells us that weeping may endure for a night, but hallelujah, joy comes in the morning. So this morning for your reading, for your hearing, for your comfort, I will be reading first of all from the Old Testament scriptures, the book of Psalms, Psalms 23, following the New Testament reading of the Gospel of St. John, chapters 14, verses 1 through 6. For your hearing, Psalms 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still water. He restoreth my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil.
All right.
For thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Old Testament scripture reading, Psalms 23. Amen. And to continuing for your hearing from the Gospel of John, John 14, verses 1 through 6. The word says, let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe in me also. In my Father's house there are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And whither I go, you know, and the way you know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we not know whither thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. May the word of God bring you comfort.
Amen. We will now have a musical selection by Sister Sharon Baptiste and Minister James Saunders.
Giving God all the glory and honor, giving love, prayers, and comfort for the family.
Poems and messages from children led by Sister Jennifer.
also representative of feelings of her other sons, Rashid, Rashad, Akita, and Taj Baig. Dear Mom, the most kindest, beautiful soul I've ever known. I wouldn't admit it, but I'm still your baby boy, even though I'm grown. I'm proud to be the son of the queen. I hope one day we can talk in my dreams. I'm writing this poem with tears in my eyes, but you're finally at peace with the one who's most high. I love you, Mom. The next one's written by Lloyd Darton, Shelley's daughter. Hey, Mom. Hey, Boo. That's what I said every time when I talk to you. The days feel longer and the nights are brief. I never imagined having to feel this grief. I'm so proud of you, and I know you did your best. You groomed us for life, so don't worry, just rest. Always in our hearts, forever in our minds, and linked to our souls. I love you so much, Hanoi. And these are words by Remy Davis, Shelley's granddaughter. Dear Nana, I love you so much. I love you so much, and I just want to spend the night with you, Nana. Your love bug. And the last poem I'm going to read is Remember Me by Anthony Dawson. Speak of me as you've always done. Remember the good times, laughter, and fun. Share the happy memories we've made. Do not let them wither and fade. I'll be with you in the summer sun and when the winter's chill has come. I'll be the voice that whispers in the breeze. I'm peaceful now, put your mind at ease. I've rested my eyes and gone to sleep. But the memories we share are yours to keep. But remember me when I was at my best. Although times may have not been the same, don't be afraid to use my name. Let your sorrow only last for a while. Comfort each other and try to smile. I lived a life filled with joy and fun. Now live on. Make me proud of what you've become. With sympathy, Hanoi, you have my deepest sympathy. I am tremendously sad for your loss. I pray the memory of your mother will comfort you and your legacy live through you all. God bless your family, sending love, hugs, and prayers to your family during this difficult time. Love, Seneca and Miss Collette. With deepest sympathy, as you walk through this season, may you experience God's constant presence. You are in all of our thoughts and prayers. May the Lord be with you and comfort you during this time, during this difficult time, the Dylan team. The spirit of a loving heart will live in memory. Hanoi and family, may you take comfort in the sweet memories of a beautiful life with sympathy. I am so sorry for your loss with deepest sympathy and love. I pray God will touch you with his healing hands and give you peace and comfort in all the happy memories. Jessica Hunters and family. What ultimately matters is not the size of your mountain, but the strength of your mountain mover. Praying you'll be encouraged during this difficult time as you see God do mighty things, sending prayers of comfort and strength and peace for rain. Remembering you in thoughts and prayers today. Hanoi, hoping it will ease your heart to know that others care and with the deepest sympathy, remember you in prayer. We love you dearly and we are praying for you and your family. Love, Allison and Ronnie. Thank you.
Thank you. to, you know, just talk about her a little bit. And, you know, everyone in here loves her, has their own memories with her. But I just kind of want to talk a little bit about kind of who she is. And I say is because I just really can't say was. This is a very real moment, yet it feels surreal at the same time. And she'll forever live on with us. So I'm going to, you know, continue to speak in the present term. You know, I stand here today, I represent my brothers as well. I'm the oldest, so sometimes that puts me in a position I have to be the strongest too. So I speak for them too, because we love our mother so, like, so dearly, and like we never imagine life without her, honestly. And death is one of those things that we know has to come, but really we never prepare for it. So I apologize if it's a little lengthy, but I have to get these things that have been marinating out. I mean, I wrote it down because I know I couldn't freestyle today. So. Okay, so I just want to talk a little bit about her new life. And I use the term new just because from the time she moved to North Carolina, I just experienced so much growth and change in my mother. And I just thought new was kind of like the term. And that's just what I want to focus on, because I said everyone has their memories. But since she lived in North Carolina, and just with everyone, our family that's in North Carolina, we've really seen her growth. And, you know, as I reflect on it, it's almost like a caterpillar transforming into a butterfly. She made amends with herself and mistakes in life. She focused more on herself and did the hard work that it takes to grow as an individual. She found peace within herself. She worked hard to grow closer to her family, and she literally cherished every day. She'd get herself up and dressed, and wore her beautiful smile and lighthearted spirit, regardless of what the day brought. She was very happy about finding peace. And I remember her telling me how amazed she was about just how much she learned about herself, how peaceful she felt. And she even made a joke about just wishing she had spent more time with herself in her earlier life. And that conversation really resonated with me. Because my mom is my strength, she's my inspiration, her and my grandmother. And, you know, I didn't directly tell her, but she indirectly encouraged me to do inner work on myself and start at this age, as she expressed to me that she wished she did it. So the peace and clarity she found, in my opinion, was really the driver behind all of her actions. Some of my thoughts from what I observed today, or excuse me, some of my thoughts of what I observed every day being with her, I really can't quite put into words. I've tried to find the words, but I can't. But those that, you know, were around her, talked to her, y'all know what I mean. She always amazed me just how much strength she exuded every single day. Even when she didn't feel well, she got up and she made it look easy. And I know part of this comforting process, you know, people tell me, you know, she's at peace, things like that. And I believe that, but maybe part of my selfishness is she made every day look so easy that I just don't want to accept that. And, you know, as I look back, it just really showed how strong of a woman she is. The love she gained for herself through her inner work, and the love she had for her family, children, and especially her love bug, Remy, as she called her, we'll never forget that. room with our family. Every birthday, Christmas, whatever we celebrated at my house, it's just she brought a different kind of energy, and it'll never be forgotten, but dearly missed. And so I just also like to just share a couple of my treasured memories with my mother. When I was younger and we lived here in Norristown, I remember being at my Aunt Lee's house and I was in her kitchen. And next thing I knew, I was balled up against the wall. And it was my mom. I don't know where she came from, but she just wrestled with me. She just came and just wrestled me from behind and had me up against the wall and like, what's up? And she would do that from time to time. But that's just one distinct one that I remember when I was younger. I have plenty of favorite memories with the Middle Park Pony Girls. And those girls consist of myself, my mom, and my grandma. That's pretty much growing up. My grandma would have Middle Park ponytails. Mom did. I do, and I did. I have one now. Remy's here now. I did one for her just for GP. And even on my messenger app, when I want to call them together or send something together, I named it Middle Park Pony Girls. So I had plenty of memories with them, but my most treasured memory is finding my first apartment in North Carolina after graduating from college. And the day that my mother passed and me and my grandma were driving to go see her, it was just very ironic because my grandma was just so upset and she just was like, what happened? And I said, well, what do you mean? And she said, Shelley's supposed to be here with us right now. And the irony is I was driving in the same direction on the same street where I was driving. My grandmother was in the driver's seat and my mom was in the back. And that was like the same exact street that we were driving down when we were doing my apartment hunting for my first apartment. My mom and I would share things, purses, clothes, you know, whatever. If I could fit hers and I liked it, I'm going to get it in the same way back. I guess that's the luxury of a mother-daughter relationship. And as I have my own daughter now, Remy tells me often, can you save this for when I get bigger? And so, you know, just when I reflect on my mom, me and my mom's relationship, I just see a lot of things that me and Remy might have now that when I was younger I didn't understand. And you know, but the funny thing with that is sometimes when I would either have my hair a certain way or, you know, I wear weave, I wear a wig, you know. If I had a nice purse or if I had a clothing item, shoes, whatever, I'll go over to my mom's house and I'd see her every day. And she'll say, that don't look good on you. And I'll just lay it, I can see it in her face. And I'm like, why? Because you want it? And she'll just start laughing. And that's one of the things, like my mom always laughed about, just the silliest things. And, you know, we all have memories of her like that. You know, another funny and memory that I'll hold on to is just our conversations about who our favorite child is. our last, more recent conversation about it, sorry, Taj, I'm pushing this back. She was telling me something about Taj, and it was a conversation she was having with someone, and I sensed she was getting like, I almost felt like offended. And I'm like, well, dang, mom, when somebody talks about me, Jamil, Rashad, like, you laugh. Like, I said, but you're getting upset about Taj, you know? And she started laughing and made this face and was like, well, that's because y'all here to defend y'all, so. And I'm like, no. Like, we would just go back and forth. I know she loved all of us dearly, but it was just a joke. Taj is the baby, and she's the favorite. You know, something that I appreciate now that I'm a mother and I'm just older and I'm doing my inner work, as I stated earlier, is both my mom and my grandma, just they've always just been very raw and real in my whole life, you know? They just, I don't know how else to say it, but it's just raw and real because life is real. But also mixed with love and compassion. And I know, you know, a lot of people don't always get that from their parents. They may get one side, not the other. But I think that's why I've grown to be such a strong woman, is just seeing them. I mean, literally, my mom and my grandma have been beating the odds, you know, with just different things health-wise or just what they've been through in their life. They've both done a lot of growing since moving to North Carolina, and it's like, gosh, is that why I was, you know, sent to North Carolina? Because I surely did not want to be in Winston-Salem. But it seems that, you know, as I look back, it seems like it turned out to be the best, and I'm just happy that I could be in a position to really help the ones that I love the most. I always enjoyed being around my mom. I could tell I was her strength, and she always was and still is mine. Her laugh made everything funnier. We'd laugh at the silliest things. I'm so grateful and blessed that I was able to give her a granddaughter whom she loved with her entire being. Remy will miss me in a minute for my mom, and that's kind of rare. She will miss me in a minute. Their love and bond is inseparable, and you know, she'll never forget her. I won't let that happen. I found this caption. I was looking through her Facebook pictures, and I think it really encapsulates everything that I'm attempting to articulate right now through this pain. I hope I make through it. And these are her words exactly. This woman has endured many hardships throughout life, had many setbacks and failures, is a survivor of affliction, but did not let it destroy her, and still managed to remain resilient and find peace, joy, and strength. That woman is me. And, you know, that really just, like I said, it really summarizes everything that I'm trying to articulate to y'all the best way that I can. And seeing her daily, she honestly found peace. She found and bought joy. You know, Remy was her joy. She wasn't having a good day. Like, she always just, if I needed help with Remy, she was always there. And strength. I mean, it's just really unbelievable how much strength she has. And honestly, it must be channeling through to me right now, because I don't know how I'm doing this. She will be extremely missed, but I'm grateful for experiencing life with her. I'm grateful for the opportunity to be the best daughter I could be and standing by her side, because I really was. My mom really, she would never really ask for help, but I could see that she needed something, and I'm just glad that I was there for her. We all were there for her, doing everything that we can. And she left us the blueprint for life, to be real but compassionate, to be strong and persevere, and to push through. And I think that's important, because now we literally have to push through every day without her. It just, it doesn't really feel right. And one last thing, my grandmother couldn't be here today. She's extremely broken. However, she is watching via the Facebook Live, and my mom, I just want to say I love you. We all love you, and you're here in spirit. And can y'all just please pray for her? She's in the hospital, so that on top of this, it's been really rough for our family. But she's strong too, so she will be okay. But Mom, I just want to say thank you so much, and we are just so proud of you, and we'll always love you. And you don't have to worry about anything. We got each other. You know, I got my brothers. They got me. And I'm a crybaby of family, but you know, we just love you so much. Our family's fine. Remy's fine. Everybody's going to be okay, and I just want you to rest peacefully and come to us when you see fit. And we're so proud of you and love you always. Thank you.
made her. She loved to read so much. I had a what I call my checkout book, and she would take so many books and never return. So I said, now you want to check out the books. Every book you take from the library, you got to check it out. Write it down. So I knew you had it, and I'll wait one day for you to bring it back. And I know there's going to be a mirror in heaven and lipstick. I would pick Shelley up, Reverend West, and everybody knows it. I was standing there, beep, 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 come on, Shelley, come on. And she told me, wait a minute, I'm coming out, Linda, I'm coming. I said, well, you come on, I gotta go. So she come and bring around the corner, right around the corner, come back. Here she comes all the way to Baltimore. I said, Shelley, we just went down the street to the store. She said, but you never know who you'll see. And I said, oh, get that. Well, we went around the corner to the store, the first one walks out. Dear sister, my niece, then three other people. And she said, see. So since then, I had my lipstick in my boots.
Miss Shelley very, very much. been in North Colorado for the last 6, 7, 8, 9 years. Only thing I can do is hear about Shelley, pray for Shelley. But all my nieces and nephews, and I got like 40 of them, maybe plus, and I love them all the same. But you gotta understand, my twin had Shelley in Carl Lake. But when she was born, it was like I had a little daughter too. It was serious. And my daughter understands what I'm saying. And my ex-wife understands what I'm saying. And not everybody in the family knows Shelley and I had like a special bond. They got put on trace calls. Rest in peace, my beautiful princess. And I mean it. Remy, see your grandmommy? She loves you very much. Okay, this is Uncle Peter. And now she knows who I am. Okay, good last time I saw her, she told like 2 years ago. Okay? So, with all my heart and soul, to all the brothers and sisters and the cousins and the relatives. And I do not want to leave out another person. CJ, I was there when CJ was born. But I know she loves Carla. I know she loved her other sister. Okay, so I just want everybody to know that. I didn't want to leave anybody out. You know, it's like the late family, you know, Suzanne. And I don't know about this Zoom call. I wonder if she sees me, but Sue, I love you. And the family loves you. And we're missing for you. And we miss you and we're praying for you. Because if she was feeling better, she'd be right sitting right there. So I just wanted to let Sue know that we love you. Your daughter Shelley. One more thing I have to say. I did not learn that when people passed away, it was the end of the world. But in some people's cases, I feel great because she's in peace. No more chemicals, no more hospital beds, no more doctor diagnosis. I'm going to be honest with you. I feel great. Not because she's not here, because she's in peace. And we got a smile. We all know Shelby smile. Okay, so my heart goes out to Hanoi, Camille, Taj, and come on. Rashad. I watched these guys get born. So it's not that I forgot their name, don't say. I love them just as much as I do Hanoi and Shelly, their mom, Carl, CJ and Nazi, and Carla. Thank you for listening. Thank you.
Shelley. I looked at her and I said, oh my gosh, she's so pretty. Look at that button nose she has. And I've been calling her button nose ever since. She's just so beautiful.
Morning, everybody. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. First of all, this wasn't planned for me to be here. I wasn't planning to do this, but the Spirit just moved me into getting up and saying something. My daughter sitting there with her head down, going, you know, my dad. You know, my dad, what are you doing? First of all, I'd like to thank God. Praise God. What's coming out of me is going to come out natural. So if I do something, it's coming from my heart. Everybody here, you might know, you may not know all the things, but my daughter was in North Carolina when I got the news and things happened. And praise God, I just want to say that there's two real warriors in here. Two young ladies that took that ball and ran with it. That's my daughter Carla Lake and my granddaughter Honora Dark. Those two from North Carolina to Norristown put their heads down and got all this together. They went to the GoFundMe, they did everything they had to do, and we're here. And that's not just easy, it's not around the corner somebody live. That's like 6 to 8 hours how to get from there up to here. And I want to thank them because they are true warriors. Did everybody get in the hand, please? Thank you so much. And then it came down, you know, we had a little issue here. I got on that phone, and they're talking, they can't do this. Sister Massey, I'd like to give her a hand round of applause for doing this and putting things together. Next phone call, they couldn't do this. I had to pick the phone up, call Salon Church, Pastor, and I was just getting ready to walk out that door, and I answered this call. And I'm thanking him too, because Pastor West just put it in motion, and things got to going on. Peter Lord, I got to talk about going Peter Lord. Peter told my car. He can do it. Next thing I know, he got into action and started doing what he's doing. And I'd like to thank all the Horton family, and it is not the Horton family, that's my family too. That's my family too. I'm married to you. I got a whole bunch of family you all know about. And I just want to thank everybody for putting this together. And most of all, I want to praise and thank God. My baby's at rest. My baby, that's my firstborn. My firstborn. When I graduated, she was born. Yeah, that's right. I had it in high school. And I ain't ashamed to say it. That's my baby. That's my first love. Me and Peter running out there. I'm playing with Pete Duggar. Peter Horton running from Norristown. You know how much stuff I got by Pop Horton? You ain't out of my house after this game over. And you know what? Allison, oh, I forgot to say that Allison. She's down there in New York. And she got on the phone. But anyway, we beat Norristown out that day, 42-7. Y'all have a blessed and praise God. Thank you.
CJ, I'm giving honor to Evangelist Kim Bishop, who found it not robbery to come share this moment and stay with us. And to give honor to that diamond sitting over there, my wife, the light of my life. Who has tirelessly worked to help the family through this time. And I thank God for her. Shelley was my niece. And I didn't get to spend a lot of time with her. But the one time that I did get to spend with her, I was down in Baltimore and got in a little situation. I was getting ready to come back to Philadelphia. And she said, Uncle Jed, come on over to my house and spend a couple of days with us, because I haven't had time and the chance to get to know you. So I went over to her house, stayed there for a few days, hung out with my nephews, took Todd fishing for the first time, and we had a great time. I'm going to miss her. I'm going to miss her, because she was my niece. Like I said, I didn't get to spend much time with her. But God did allow me time. And I thank God for that. And this is not a time, to feel sorrow. It's not a time to feel sad. We come to celebrate her today. 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 Not in death, but in life. Because she's about to have another life in a place called heaven. Paradise. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Y'all sitting here, y'all sitting around, and you're looking sad. But we come to celebrate the life of Shelley Lake. Hallelujah.
Grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, I will boast all the more gladly about my weaknesses, so that Christ's power may rest on me. That is why, for Christ's sake, I delight in weaknesses, in insults, in hardships, in persecutions, in difficulties. For when I am weak, today we gather together in this sacred place that was Shelley Lake's spiritual home. Today we remember our dear sister and how we got to know her and appreciate her as part of the Shiloh Baptist Church family. But now our sister has slipped away from life. So we come together in this, her chosen place of worship, looking for the comfort and peace that passes all understanding. So often we view death as a failure, a defeat. But if you know Jesus, and Jesus knows you, let me say that again. If you know Jesus, and Jesus knows you, even death is crowned with victory. You see, we are all going to die. We're all going
going to breathe our last breath, pray our last prayer, but if we know Jesus, we believe there is life beyond the grave. Am I right about that? I'm here. I have no doubt that Sister Shelley had some great days, some happy days, some wonderful days. Is that right, Dad?
Yes, sir.
But everything in life is not good. Everything in life doesn't make us happy. And everything we experience in life is not satisfying. Somebody can say amen.
Amen.
Life also has its problems. Can I get a witness here?
Amen.
If you live long enough, you will learn that everything will not go your way in this life. Especially if you're a married man. Isn't that right? The Bible says that we are told that Paul had a problem. Some say it was physical illness. Some say it was a problem in the church. But whatever it was a problem that just would not go away. He could not think it away. He could not cry it away. He could not work it out. No matter what he did, the problem always was still there. No doubt, Sister Shelley knew something about having problems in her life. And I have no doubt that in the quietness of her heart, she asked the Lord to take her problems away.
Amen.
And I say to you, family, I know that you're hurting today. I know that you wish you could have your loved one, your mother, your friend, your cousin, your boo-boo, whatever it may be, your sister, your relative. But my message is to you is that God does not always take away the pain, but he gives us his grace. He gives us his mercy. And in times like this, he gives us his love. God does not always take away the problems, the hurts, the disappointments, but he gives us something to overcome the problems, to handle the hurts, and to deal with the disappointments that come our way. And I don't care who you are or how holy you are, there are times when you are under attack by the enemy, but greater is he that is within you. Saved a wretch like me. I once understand that what we're doing today isn't just for today, but literally thousands and thousands of years from now, the commitment we've made to God and God has made to us shall keep us one with the Father, one with the Son, one with the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Father, we thank you and we praise you for this beautiful person and this beautiful life. And our prayer is, Lord, that right now she is beginning her eternal experience with you. You said in your word that you would provide a place for us. Now, Father, we pray that our sister has found her place. May we leave here, Lord, with confidence, with hope, yea, God, even joy. For there's no more crying up there. There's no more fussing up there. Ain't no more cuss words up there. Hello. There's only Jesus. There's only the love of the Holy Spirit. And there's only the presence of God. We pray that our sister is enjoying her place with God. And that one day, we shall all be together again, giving thanks to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. May the people of God who believe that say amen.
Amen.
Amen. May we stand for the benediction. After the formal benediction, we will complete the internment process at that time. If you wish to stay for that, you are welcome to do so. Father, we thank you for what our eyes have seen, our ears have heard, and our hearts have felt. We thank you for our dear blessed sister whose life we celebrate and remember today. We ask, O God, that you will give us fond and loving memories not just last for the hour, it will last forever. But most of all, God, there's one we can never forget, and that's you. We pray that you will be our giver of perfect peace, of love and joy. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. God bless you. You may be seated for our committal service.
Thank you.